Hey there, welcome back to The Magic and the Music. I'm Jen. You know, a lot of people have questions about whether they will actually save money with Disney Vacation Club. And the math is fairly obvious if you are going to stay at a deluxe resort, but we wanted to really put DVC to the test. So today we are comparing a Disney World value resort stay with a DVC stay at a similar resort. Well, kind of similar. So today's big question is, can you actually save money with DVC if you normally stay in value resorts at Disney World? Let's dig into the numbers and check it out. Now, of course, we all know that a Disney DVC resort is considered a deluxe resort, and so comparing it to a value resort in terms of amenities is not going to be a fair comparison, but we're going to focus in on the numbers today. We have decided to compare a 7-night stay at Disney's All-Star Movies Resort with a 7-night stay at Disney's Old Key West Resort. Yes, the original DVC resort. We selected these two resorts because they are both very large resorts. They are similar distances to the theme parks, meaning that you do have to take a bus or drive to the theme park from those resorts. And they feel kind of like a similar scale to me. We chose a week in June of 2022, Saturday to Saturday, 7 nights. Our sample dates are June 11th through June 18th, 2022. Now, for those of you who are familiar with Disney Vacation Club, you know that stays are paid for in terms of points. So our stay would take 92 points to stay at Old Key West in a studio villa. This would be the closest villa type at Old Key West, most similar to a hotel room. Now, of course, some DVC villas sleep 5, some sleep 4, but basically a studio villa is roughly equivalent to a regular hotel room. So first, let's take a look at the cash stay, which is the regular hotel booked through Disney's central reservation system. The full price for a standard room is $173.71 average per night. The total cost with tax would be $1,380.17. Sometimes you can get a room-only discount from Disney, but these discounts tend to be fairly low in the value category. I've never seen one over about 15%. So you would also need to travel in an off-peak season to get one of these discount offers. Since none of these are currently available, we are going to be using the full price room cost of $1,380.17. And you might say, but Jen, what about packages? Don't you save money with packaging your theme park tickets along with the room? Well, not much. Really, the savings are pretty minimal, and so I'm not even really factoring that into this. As soon as you start adding in the hotel room with the tickets, it gets very difficult to make price comparisons, so we're just going to avoid that altogether. Now, you might be wondering, where did I get this price? We took the full price rate directly from the Disney World website. Discounts are only available for certain travel windows, so you may not actually be able to get one of these room discounts. Before we get to the comparison, I'd like to take a quick moment to ask you to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. It's easy, quick, free, and it helps our channel out a lot. Even better, leave us a comment about what type of resorts you like to stay in at Disney. Are you a guest who typically stays in value resorts, but you are interested in learning more about DVC? Let us know what kind of Disney guest you are. Thanks so much. Back to our comparison. All right, so it's time for the Disney Vacation Club cost comparison. Let's assume that you're using Old Key West points that you bought directly from Disney for $180 per point. Now, that is the current price to purchase it directly from Disney. If you bought them earlier, this is going to be a different number, a lower number. If you bought those points today, you would get 2057, the expiration date of those points, minus current year. That gives us a total of 36 years of points remaining. So you have 36 years of points left on that contract if you bought it today. Divide the $180 per point cost, and if you have closing costs and other numbers you could add in, that would add a little bit to it, but we're just gonna keep the math simple for right now. $180 per point divided by 36 years, and you get, nice easy number, $5 per point. Add the annual dues to that, which are currently for 2022, $8.81 per point. Your points cost you $13.81 per point. Now with that number, we can figure out the cost of the stay. Now multiply that by the number of points needed for the reservation, which is 92, and your reservation will cost you $1,270.52. Oh, but we're not done right there. We are going to take it one step farther and we are going to calculate it for a DVC resale purchase. Yes, you can buy DVC secondhand. If you bought those same points on the resale market for approximately $120 per point, we're going to do the same math. 36 years of points. Divide your purchase price, $120 per point, by 36 years, and you would get $3.33 per point. Then you're going to add in the $8.81 in maintenance fees, and you get a total of $12.14 per point. Now multiply that by the points needed for the reservation, in this case, 92 points, and the stay cost you $1,117.19. So are there any hidden costs, you might be wondering? Well, there can be. Parking is an extra $15 per night at a value resort. So for 7 nights, that's an additional $105 if you choose to bring a car. If you don't, you can just leave that number out of your calculation. Now, you may be able to get a discount on your value stay. But another issue that can arise with these discounts is that, in my experience, the discounts are often mostly available only for upgraded views or room types, which have a higher starting price point than a standard room. Yes, you'd be getting a discount, but the discount is taken from a more expensive room, increasing the overall cost, or maybe just leaving it at roughly the same price as the standard room to begin with. The difference in these standard and preferred rooms is basically just location. Preferred rooms are closer to the lobby, food, main feature pool, and sometimes they have nicer views too. So you can see here, if you generally stay at value resorts at Disney World, it may be worth taking a look at Disney Vacation Club. It's not a slam dunk. We started off staying at value resorts ourselves, and then we moved over to moderate resorts, and we found that we could definitely save money by buying DVC. The math is not quite so clear if you stay in value resorts. It is definitely, for us, it was very clear that we could save over being in a moderate resort. Value resort, it was a little bit closer. On the other hand, if you're like us and you would prefer to stay in a much nicer resort with more convenient accommodations for about the same price as a value resort, now DVC might be worth checking out for you. The key thing to remember here is that even though DVC resorts are considered to be in the deluxe category, there is actually some variation among the different resorts. Some are more upscale and newer than others, and some have better locations than others, and most importantly, some are much more costly in terms of points than others. For example, if we did the same calculation with Bay Lake Tower, Riviera, or the Grand Floridian, it would surely be more expensive to stay in that DVC room. While staying at Old Key West, Saratoga Springs Boardwalk Villas, or Animal Kingdom Lodge DVC resorts are going to keep the costs fairly low. But Jen, what about rental? Well, we didn't forget about rental either. If you're not comfortable making the commitment of buying DVC, you can always rent another member's points for your next stay. We checked out the exact same room on a popular DVC rental website, and we were quoted $1,748 for the same Old Key West room. Yes, this is more expensive than staying at the value resort, but it could be a good option if you'd like to try out DVC without the commitment of actually buying a contract. So as you can see, the math is going to be very individual. It's going to depend on your situation. If you stay in deluxe resorts all the time, DVC is a slam dunk. There's no question. If you stay in moderate resorts often, Disney Vacation Club, for many of those people, can be a really good savings. If you tend to be a guest who stays in value resorts all the time or most of the time, DVC may end up kind of being a wash or being very similar in cost to your value resort. One thing we can always assume is that the cost is going to go up on those Disney value resorts. I remember days where I was booking value resorts for under $100. Those days are gone. You just don't see those kind of discounts anymore. And once you buy your DVC contract, that money has been paid and the price is set. Yes, you have dues, but they are not going to go up in the way that the cost of the hotel rooms is going to go up throughout the year. So that's something to consider. Of course, the experience is going to be a little bit different too between your DVC resort and your value resort. So you just have to really look at your individual situation and see what is the best fit for you and your family. If you want to learn more about Disney Vacation Club, be sure to check out our other DVC educational videos, full of tips, tricks, and ideas to help you get the most out of your DVC membership. And if you're considering purchasing a contract directly from Disney, check out the description below for a link that can save you money on a direct purchase. We also have a video just like this one comparing the cost of a Disney World moderate resort and a DVC stay. Click right here to go to that video. And check out this playlist here to learn more about DVC, including room and resort tours. Yeah, the fun stuff. Thank you so much for joining us, and have a great day, everybody. Bye.